आजच्या व्हिडिओमध्ये आपण जावास्क्रिप्ट आरे पाहणार आहोत, तर त्यामध्ये नेक्स्ट पॉइंट आहे असोसिएटिव्ह आरे. तर असोसिएटिव्ह आरे, असोसिएटिव्ह आरे मीन्स व्हॉट? आरे विथ नेम्ड इंडेक्स आर कॉल्ड एज अ असोसिएटिव्ह आरे. नाउ देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ आरे, आरे विथ नेम्ड इंडेक्स अँड आरे विथ नंबर्ड इंडेक्स. बट व्हॉट हॅपन, जावास्क्रिप्ट डज नॉट सपोर्ट आरे विच हॅविंग नेम्ड इंडेक्स. That means JavaScript does not support associative array. Okay, JavaScript always support only array with numbered index. Okay, so what happen if we use JavaScript array as a named index? That means associative array. Then it will not create array. So let us see the example. Now here var person. Okay, we have just declared array. Then person of first name is equal to John. Here we have used named index. Again person of last name is equal to Doe. Again here we have used what? Named index. Again person of age is equal to 46. Again here we have used named index. But JavaScript does not support named index, that is associative array. So where x is equal to person dot length. If we run this program, you will get that person length value will be 0. If we write where y or is equal to person of 0, then person of 0 will return undefined. Okay, so that means JavaScript does not support associative array. Now let us see next point, that is function. Okay, this topic is consist of three part: array, function and string. So array is completed. Now let us start the function. Now what is a function? JavaScript function is a block of code designed to perform particular task. Function is always performing some specific task. And function is executed when it invokes it. When we call the function, at that time it is executed. So let us see how to define function. Okay. Let us see how to define function. Now function is defined using a syntax. Okay. So function syntax is defined with the function keyword. Function keyword is must. Function is defined using function keyword, then followed by function name, and then followed by the parenthesis. Parenthesis means opening closing rounded bracket. It having parameters. Parameter 1, 2, 3, dot, 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 dot. And inside here code to be executed. Okay. The function keyword, then name, then parenthesis. Inside the parenthesis there is a parameter. So let us see. Now again I am writing that explanation, function names. Now function name can contain letters, digits, underscores, dollar sign, but it having the names of rules of the variables. Now parenthesis include the parameters, parameter 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. And the last part, sorry, here opening closing curly brackets. Inside the curly bracket what should we write? Code to be executed. Code to be executed right inside the curly bracket. Now let us see the example. Now let us see function, function keyword, my function, name of function, and the parenthesis. Inside the parenthesis there is parameter p1, p2. Function, my function is a function name, p1, p2 are the parameters. And here code to be executed, return p1 into p2. Okay. Now, if we call these functions, now HTML body, here header tag is to script tag. Now here our JavaScript tag is programming start, script tag. Inside the script tag, now function is defined, function, my function p1, p2, return p1, p2. This is a function code. This is a function defined. Here we have defined the function. Okay. Function, my function, p1, p2, return p1 into p2. And here we have called the function. Now what we have called? My function 4, 3. Here 4 and 3 value is supplied here. The product of 4 into 3, 12 is written, stored into the variable x. And document.write method will display the value of x. Okay. So this is a program. If we call this program, we are getting such type of output, JavaScript functions 12. Now 12 is a product and JavaScript function is displayed because of this header tag. because of this header tag JavaScript function is defined and the product is displayed here. This value display the 12. Okay, so I hope that you understand this topic, and if you having any doubt, then you can ask me.